Hello everyone, welcome back to Altium Academy. I'm your host, Zach Peterson, and today we are going to be talking about the right way to manage libraries for projects and for your entire company. Should you have one library? Should you do project-based libraries? I feel like this is the $6 million question when it comes to PCB data management. So that's what we're gonna get into in this video. Let's go ahead and jump in and get started. So in this video, we're going to talk about library management on a project or company-wide basis. And this all came up from a comment on our recent Via and Pad templates or Pad stacks video. Let's take a look. Ahmad writes, "Thank you very much. I actually switched from Fusion to Altium because of you. Super helpful video." Well, thank you very much, Ahmad. "It would be awesome if you could make a video about working with libraries in Altium, copying, editing parts, and especially how you handle this in practice." Now, I want to zoom out here to focus on one important point in this question. He asks, and the big question, one library to rule them all, or does each project get its own library? Would love to hear your thoughts. This is such a huge question when it comes to project data management, because sometimes you can make the case that a project-based approach actually is the right approach. And in a lot of cases, having a single library with one person or one team of people tasked with overseeing all the data in that library really is the best approach. It really depends on what your role in the design process is. Are you a freelancer? Are you a contract engineer or contract designer? Do you work for an OEM or an ODM? Do you work for a manufacturer? It really depends. So I think your role in the PCB design process and who you work for is really going to be key to answering that question. So let's go ahead and jump on the whiteboard and we can look at some of the processes that are used in each of these cases to manage components. Now, so far we've looked at the case where you might be working at a company that manufactures its own products or that contracts with, for example, EMS company to get its products manufactured. In that case, you're maintaining a central library and pulling all the components from that central library to create your designs. But what if you're working as a freelance designer, or maybe you work at a contract engineering company, or maybe you work at a PCB design services firm? What do you do in that case? Well, in that case, you don't just have your central library that you have to pull data from, but you also have a client involved. And having a client involved always changes the strategy that you have to use to manage the data for a project. So let's just say, for example, we have our library, we have a client that wants a design created, and we're going to call that design project number one. Now, sometimes what happens is the client comes to you and they say, we need to have this design created, but they don't have any CAD data. They don't have any circuits created. They don't know anything, right? They're just coming to you getting a design created. And that means you're gonna have to leverage all of the CAD data yourself in order to work on this project. So that's the case where you still wanna have a centralized master library with all of your components from past projects and your own standard enforced in that library to ensure that all of that CAD data is consistent. And you're gonna pull all of that CAD data from your library into that project. Now, once this design is completed and the project is closed, you have to deliver some deliverables to the client. Now, of course, the deliverables are the native CAD files, the manufacturing outputs, any documentation that you're required to create. But one thing that I always think is important to deliver with the final project files is a project library, because the client is going to take all of these files, they're going to put them on your computer somewhere, or they're going to store them in the cloud or whatever they do with them, but they're going to take all of those files and put them in an archive somewhere and hold on to them in case they need to access them later. They might go off to another design firm in the future. You don't know what's necessarily going to happen, but the bottom line is you want to make sure that they have a complete project archive, including a project library with all of the CAD data needed to regenerate that native PCB file. And that's exactly what you want to give them. So all of this project library data ultimately gets pulled from your personal centralized library that you maintain as a freelance designer or as someone who's working at a small design company. Now, sometimes what happens is the clients actually do know something about PCB design or about electronics design, and they may come to you with their own library. And this is actually something I have to deal with pretty often as someone who works on designs on a contract basis. Clients oftentimes do show up with their own libraries and with their own library standards on the footprints that they want to put into a design. And so they're coming to you with CAD data, and you have to remember the client is ultimately writing the check and ensuring that you get paid. So if a client shows up with their own library, you have a responsibility to use the data in their library in the design. So you're ultimately going to be pulling the data from their library into this project. Now, a lot of times the client shows up with a library, but they don't just need you to use that library. They need you to do some original design work as well. And so you might be pulling in data from your own library into their library, and then you pull that into the project, or you just pull it into the project directly. You might even need to get some of this CAD data from a third-party source, something like a Snapmagic or the manufacturer part search panel in Altium, one of these sources to get components. And you're going to pull some data from that source as well and pull it into the project. So you're getting some library data from all of these sources and pulling it into this project. And so what do you do at the end of that project? Well, I think you still need to create a single master project library from the CAD data that ends up in the schematics and in the PCB. This is really important because you're pulling all of this data from a variety of sources, but you want to make sure that you compile all of that data into one location. That way, it can be used as the master reference for all of the CAD data in this project. So at the end of the project, when you create the manufacturing outputs and you zip up all of the native CAD files into a zip folder, you also want to export a master project library, and then you give all of this stuff back to the client at the end of the project. Now, once you do this project library export and deliver it to the client might not be an Altium user, but of course, if they become an Altium user in the future, they can take these file-based exports and then they can create their own centralized library in a company workspace, and they can use Altium's library migration tools to very quickly and easily get these project libraries into their company workspace, and then they're going to be able to also enforce all of that consistent CAD data across their projects. So if you're a client or you're a PCB designer and you need to do some of these basic library management tasks for your PCB projects, how can you do this with Altium's tools? Well, if you're a designer and you're completing a project and you want to export file-based libraries for a client, that is very easy to do. You can use the library export tools in the schematic or in the PCB editor. You can create a schematic library file inside of one of your schematics. Just open a schematic sheet, go to Design and Make Schematic Library, and you will be able to export a schematic library for all of your parts inside of your project. Next, what about the PCB footprints? Well, you can do the same thing inside the PCB editor for a PCB library file. To create a PCB library file from your project, go to the Design menu and select Make PCB Library, and you can then export all of the footprints in your project into a PCB lib file. Now, what if you have file-based libraries and you want to get them into a centralized library so that you can enforce consistent CAD data and supply chain data across all your projects? What can you do? Once you have your schematic symbols, footprints, 3D models, and simulation models in your company workspace, you can then reuse them to create new components quickly and easily. Thank you very much for this great question. This is really an important question, and I hope that the advice I've given here will help you figure out a library management and data management strategy for your company. Make sure to hit that like button, hit the subscribe button, leave your comments and questions in the comment section, and of course, don't forget to call your fabricator, folks. We'll see you next time.